Hello and welcome to this video. I'm Andy, and in this video I will look deeper into it, how long it takes for economic units and buildings to pay back their initial cost. I will start off this video by explaining my assumptions, then I will go deeper into the economic units, so that will mostly be the villagers, and after that I will take a look at the economic buildings, so that would be for example the banks or the shrines. I will edit the main points into the video. And in the background there's some gameplay of a ranked match I played. So I want to start this video with a quote from one of my favorite pro players, IsomK. He said, Age of Empires 3 is probably the one real-time strategy game where having fast hands matters a lot less than knowing the game. So let's follow his advice and use the biggest leverage there is to becoming better in this game, which is to explore more details in this game, which we'll do in this video. So let's go! Okay, so let's talk about assumptions. So because we have four resources in this game, that will be food, wood, gold and experience, we need to take that into account. We do this by calculating the equivalent food cost or gather rate. This is because food is gathered the fastest while the other resources are gathered slower. So for the scope of this video, I will assume that 100 food is worth 100 food obviously. Then 100 wood is worth 125 food and 100 gold is worth 115 food. And 100 XP for me is also worth 100 food. For the villager gather rates, I use the gather rates of the Hunts without any upgrades or cards. Okay, so let's compare the economic units. I will start with the generic villager. So the generic villager costs 100 food, gets produced in 25 seconds in the TC and gathers at a rate of 0.84 food per second. Now we have everything we need to calculate our break-even time for our villager. Remember, the break-even time is the time until a villager has gathered its costs and from that moment on your investment was worth and your villager is producing value for you. I calculate the break-even time with this formula. So I divide the food equivalent cost of a villager, which is 100 food, by the food equivalent gather rate, which is 0.84 food per second. After that, I add the production time of the TC, so that would be 25 seconds. On top of it, because your villager doesn't spawn immediately. Okay, so by doing that calculation, we calculate a break-even time for a generic villager of 2 minutes and 24 seconds. For a French villager, the break-even time is 2 minutes and 25 seconds, and for a settler wagon, the break-even time is 2 minutes and 12 seconds. Let's talk about a Japanese villager a bit, because the Japanese villager can't hunt, so he only can gather from berries, he takes 30 seconds more to break even. The Indian villager costs wood and the Dutch villager costs gold, so that's why the break-even time is higher than a generic villager. So what about Russian villagers? Russia villagers get produced in packs of 3 and they take 53 seconds to produce. So that means that Russian villagers get produced 30% faster than generic villagers, while also costing 10% less. Sounds good, right? But because your villagers are spawned in packs of 3, that also means that your first villager can't start gathering at 25 seconds and they all start gathering at 53 seconds. How does that affect the break-even time? Well, the Russian villagers have a break-even time of 2 minutes and 40 seconds, so that means they take longer to break even than generic villagers. The last unit I want to talk about is the fishing boat. So the fishing boat takes 25 seconds to produce and costs 70 wood, while having a food gather rate of 0.67 food per second. With schooners you can reduce the time to produce to 15 seconds and also the cost to 50 seconds. It means they have a break-even time of 2 minutes and 36 seconds without schooners and with schooners 1 minute and 48 seconds. That doesn't take into account the cost of a dock, so that means we assume that the dock is already built. Okay, so for the summary, I put all the gather rates in a nice little diagram. So the unit that breaks even the fastest is the fishing boat with schooners. And the weakest villagers are the Indian villagers and the Japanese villagers, because the Indian villagers cost wood and the Japanese villager gathers slower from berries. The Russian and the Dutch villagers take a bit longer to break even than the generic villagers, And CDBs, settler wagons, and generic villagers have around the same break-even time. To conclude this part, I would say that villagers take around 2 to 3 minutes to break even. Remember, the calculations were all done without upgrades and also without taking into account idle time or walking time. So yeah, in reality, the break-even time is around 2 to 3 minutes, depending on how the game is going. Okay, so now to the second part. How long does it take for economic buildings to break even? This part I will look at trading posts, at churches, at banks, at shrines, Inca houses, torps, and British manor houses. So most buildings can only be built by villagers, so I have to take into account the time they spend building the building, which they can't use to gather resources. So that means the total food equivalent cost for buildings is the cost in wood plus the building time of the villagers times the gather rate for food. Shrines and trading posts can be built by explorers, so that means you're not losing villager seconds and consequently resources by doing that. Okay, so let's start with trading posts. The rate I found is that they gather at a rate of 1.1 experience per second, which translates into a break-even time of 4 minutes and 12 seconds. Without advanced trading post and with advanced trading post, they pay back in 2 minutes and 41 seconds. Let's quickly talk about shrines. Shrines have a base gather rate of 0.14 food per second without any animals and upgrades on it. And for each animal you get 0.08 food per second. For each livestock the gather rate goes up by 0.14 and you can have maximum of 4 animals or livestock around your shrines. So the upgrades all affect only the base rate, which means Heavenly Kami gives you 0.07 food per second. For the calculation, I put in a shrine without upgrades and without animals, a shrine with animals, and a fully upgraded shrine, and also a variant where I take into account the full discount you can achieve with Japanese, with the Portuguese allies and the Heavenly Kami, where shrines only cost 75 wood. The last thing I want to talk about is the torp. I assume that you build your torp around a mine, that's the most common place to place a torp, and that you don't have any animals or trees around it. I also look at how long it takes for torps to repay if ironworks and blueberry bushes has already been sent. Okay, so I put all the break-even times into a diagram and let's quickly talk about it. So by far the best economic building is the torp if you send the 2 cards, blueberry bushes and ironworks. And even without the cards, if you just place the torp around a mine, they are already better than banks. Then the second thing which is interesting, I think, that if you shrine boom, you want to get all the shrine boom things. So you want to get all the discounts and all the upgrades, then your shrines are really good and pay back in around 3 minutes. So one more thing that's really interesting to me is that manors take 5 minutes to pay back. So initially I thought, or my gut feeling was that the British boom is one of the best in the game. But compared to the other building booms there are in the game, the British manor boom is average. One more thing to note about trading posts. Trading posts are all without upgrades. If you do the upgrades, you can switch the trading posts to wood, for example, and then they pay back even faster than they already do. That just goes to show how good trading routes are if you can manage to hold them. Okay, so let's summarize. What are the best economic buildings in the game currently? Without any upgrades, the torp is the best and closely followed by the trading post. With upgrades, the torp is by far the best economic building you can get in the game at the moment. After that comes the trading post with the advanced trading post upgrade card. After that the shrine boom if you can manage to land your shrines on animals and have all the upgrades and the shrine wonder. And after that come the Inca houses with only one card. The most surprising thing for me is how long British and Dutch buildings take to pay back their initial cost. Okay, so let's do a quick summary of this video. Villagers and fishing boats take 2 to 3 minutes to break even. Without any upgrades, the generic villager breaks even the fastest. And with upgrades, fishing boats with schooners pay back the fastest. Generally, you can say that economic units are better than economic buildings. With very few exceptions, so that would be for example the trading route with upgrades. And also the torp boom with the cards is also better. Okay, so this will be the end of this video. I hope you learned something. Did I forget something? Then just write it in the comments. And I will see you guys around. Bye bye.